to the channel. We are doing Red Dead Redemption 2. Hopefully the issue has solved itself with this new PC and we'll be able to continue the game. That being said, we'll check our progress since it's been quite a while since we're at 45%. Total completion is 36%. So without further delay, let's hop in there.
It's me, Arthur.
Welcome back, Arthur.
Been a long time since we played this. This mission has been glitched on the other PC, but hopefully this PC will be able to handle it. And we'll be able to finish this one out. At least continue this game. I'm gonna hitch up the horse right here. Surprising I remember how to do that.
Not too bad. That's
good. This is the mission that's been glitched.
Jose?
Hey, Arthur.
The Gilded Cage.
We're gonna make it to this party. We sure as shit better clean up a little.
So we're doing this?
Oh, yeah. Old friend Dutch van der Linde is finally showing his true colors. Social climbing.
Old Senor Bronte, that horrendous snake, has invited us to the ball, Cinderella. So my suggestion is we go and get you a gown.
You son of a bitch.
We are ridiculous.
Utterly.
I ain't never been to a ball in my life.
Nor have I, if I am being honest.
I used to quite often. There can be fine pickets.
Oh, no. No pickpocketing. We are here to make real contact.
What kind of contact?
Well, I don't know. We'll find what we can. All I know for sure is we are going to a party at the mayor's house, and the guest of honor is the worst crook in town. I am sure that we will find something.
Okay.
Gentlemen, Luca, I'm afraid the mayor does not allow guns at official functions after last year's incident. Luca here will take you to Mr. Bronte. I believe he is expecting you.
Follow me, gentlemen. This way, please, gentlemen. Senior Bronte will be so pleased that you made it.
We are honored to be here.
Ah, that's wonderful, wonderful. Come, this way. What a beautiful evening it shall be. Mr. Bronte is a very good friend with the mayor. Good evening, Pierre.
Senor Napoli?
As long as the mayor behaves himself, you know. Mr. Bronte, he has the thing, you know. Respect.
Jose, Bill, you join the party. We'll meet you out back after we pay our respects to Senor Bronte.
Come.
We'll meet you out in the balcony when you're done.
Boys, you've arrived, and you've washed per la prima volta questo mese senza dubbio. Oh.
This is quite a party you've invited us to.
Yes, quite something, although I'm not quite sure what.
So, this is Saint Denis High Society.
Yes, apparently so.
And all these people, these are friends of yours, Senor Bronte?
No, not quite. But they certainly are afraid of me. Like that one. See, that wretch? He's the mayor. Henri Lemieux. He'll do anything for a dollar, and I mean anything.
Politics is a foul business. Yes.
Oh, and that one, too. That is Alberto Fusar. He owns a sugar plantation out on the island, and he comes here to whore and despoil himself. and that is Hobart Crawley, a Confederate major in the war. I mean, hero, they say, but this is his very young wife, I mean, a young mistress, that's the natural order of things. Yes, but a young wife is unseemly. Oh, the Redskins. I have no sympathy for them, because whoever is stupid enough to get tricked by the Americans, no, they get what they deserve, huh? Yes, and a letter to the mayor. Oh, yeah, that'll save you. And that is Hector Fellows. This self-righteous newspaper man. Maybe you will kill him for me one day.
Well, we're not paid killers as such. Not in cold blood, anyway.
I did not know you were so particular that you wouldn't help a friend.
Oh, I'm willing to help in any way I can, within reason.
I'm going to pretend to understand what that means.
I meant no offense, sir.
None taken. All these vulgar people. They hate me. Non vedo l'ora di guardarti morire.
Well, it has been wonderful conversing with you, but I can tell that you are very busy, and I won't waste any more of your time.
Yes, yes, yes. Go, enjoy yourselves, and mingle with this vulgar scum. It'll make you long for the days when you could shoot each other and screw cows out on the open range.
Those sure were the days. Good day, gentlemen.
Good day to you. But before you go, what exactly are your plans here?
Well, we've not made any... Well, we are going to need some money.
Money, yes, of course. But there's money at the trolley station. They keep a lot of cash there in the day. Now, I could not involve myself in such matters. But you... As a guest, yes. As my guest, bah, do it, huh? Okay, good day, gentlemen.
Goodbye.
Okay, ragazzi, adesso il vino buono.
I'll show you to the party, gentlemen, if you'll kindly...
Yeah, the stairs is where we always have trouble. The game glitches when we get to the stairs. On the old PC. However, the new PC, hopefully it's not going to recreate itself.
Gentlemen, enjoy your evening and welcome once again to Saint-Denis. Ciao, ciao.
Gentlemen, let's go ingratiate ourselves.
Good evening, sir.
Okay. Go find the mayor if you can, and stay out of trouble, and steal nothing unless it's information.
Of course.
Jose, you go find us someplace to rob. Bill, go make us some new friends. I'm gonna find out if old Cornwall, and what's his name, Milton, knows we're here. Gentlemen, be well.
Well, that's a good sign. We have never made it this far without the game having killed itself.
Suggested that all of us as Americans had a duty to take care of people living in this land, and that extends to Saint-Denis.
It ain't complex, Lemieux, and only an idiot like you, buddy, would try to make it so.
I will not deny idiocy, sir, but perhaps now is not the time.
Typical pansy!
You are drunk, Ferdinand.
I'm not drunk, you fool. But this man loves darkies.
Hey, you are pretty drunk. What say you and me cool off?
Get your hands off me.
Come on, sleep it off. Sit down and calm down.
Count to 1,000.
Then you can rejoin the party.
Thank you, sir.
My pleasure.
Henri Lemieux. I hope you're enjoying my party.
The mayor.
Allegedly.
That's quite a place you got here.
It's not mine, and the city is horribly in debt, but we can still put on a good show. Do you know Evelyn Miller?
My lord. The writer?
Well, we seem to have another deranged drunkard on our hands.
Shall we?
Oh, my lord, they're fantastic.
Excuse me, father. Excuse me, father. Monsieur, please. Mr. Cornwall was quite insistent, I'm afraid. He shouted down the telephone for several minutes.
Mr. Cornwall is a horse's ass, and a bad horse.
I'm very sorry, sir.
No, it's not your fault. I'm a fool for trusting him. I'll come in and sign it in a minute. Let me enjoy the fireworks.
Of course.
Can you say something about Cornwall?
Yes. Find out what. Sure.
Problems?
Everything's fine. We have the place well secured.
Good. Mr. Bronte has a habit of wandering about and reading whatever he likes.
We're watching him and his men like hawks.
Thank you, Mr. Terrapin.
Everything taken care of? The telephone, it keeps ringing.
The mayor said he will sign later.
Marie! Marie! Find that little reprobate Chip and beat him! I will not have standards slip in this house! Have you lost your mind? I said, have you lost your mind? Come here. Come here. Look at me. Look at me. Who do you think you are? This area is not meant for the likes of you. You know this. Standards in this house are slipping. This is a final warning to you, miss. A final warning. Now get out of my sight.
Mr. Leviticus Cornwall. Top secret. Extremely confidential. Very interesting.
Hello there. good day, sir.
Find anything?
I think so.
Nothing. This town is a waste of time.
Maybe not.
I think... Gentlemen, I think we're done here.
What did you find out?
There's plenty of money moves through here, of course, and I think I found out how we can grab some of it. Big bank. Real one, I mean. But not yet.
A city bank?
Maybe. And a stuffed one. If we're gonna leave, that could be the one thing we need.
There's also that trolley car station Senor Bronte told us about, and I heard about a high-stakes poker game. Come on. Here comes Lenny. All right. Let's get in. Go home.
Oh, I ain't never felt so awkward in all my life. All them folk all so pleased with themselves. Oh, high society's pigeon shit. If you ask me, it's more like torture.
Well, that's sort of the point, isn't it? Let the people torture themselves.
Here's them papers I took.
Anybody see you take this?
I don't think so.
I might have an idea. Let me think on it.
Well, that was interesting. Interesting, because we actually got through it.
Interesting times.
I guess. So what's next? Dancing lessons? Deportment?
More along the lines of armed robbery. Jose is handling reconnaissance on the bank. He and Abigail are going to run some distractions, see how the law reacts.
Good.
Oh, and I spoke to Evelyn Miller. Fine man. Here helping the Indian chief we saw.
Yeah, I met him too, with the mayor.
He's lobbying officials in Saint-Denis on their behalf. Maybe we could help.
Maybe.
Now, I think there's a lot of money on the riverboat. A lot of money. And Trelawney, he's investigating for us. He says to meet him at the tailor's.
Okay.
One big score down here, Arthur, and we disappear. We are almost heading home.
Where is home?
I don't know. Exactly. But I can smell it. I'm gonna go investigate this trolley thing old Bronte was talking about.
Okay.
All right, we finally got that mission complete. And I'm very freaking happy about that because we've been trying to get this mission done for about 6 freaking months now. So, anyway, I think we're going to leave it right there because this is what we pretty much wanted to get done, and we got it done, this mission. So now that this mission is done and complete, we can continue to play the remainder of the game, which is a big win for me, a big win. Been wanting to do this game for a while. So that being said, look forward to the next video. We should have videos almost daily on this, or at least maybe 3 in a week or so, depending on how pumped I get into it. So anyway, look forward to that. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.